Hello student, in last video we were doing numericals of chapter 2nd day in class 10 subject physics. So today we will continue from question number 7. Okay, we are doing chapter 2nd day numericals. So question number 7 is, a water pump raises 50 liter of water. Liter is unit of volume. Volume is equal to 50 liter. Through the height of 25 meter in 5 seconds. T is 5 seconds. Calculate the power of pump required. We have to find power of pump. So as you know, power is given by P is equal to W over T. So for calculate power of pump, first we have to calculate work done by the pump. So work done by the pump will be MGH upon T. Now in this formula MGH over T, we need value of G, H and value of M in kilogram. But we have mass, but we have volume of water, not the mass. So always remember, 1 liter is equivalent to 1 kg. 1 liter is equivalent to 1 kg. So here mass of water is 50 kilogram. So P is equal to mass M into G 10 upon H, sorry, into H 25 upon 5. 25 watt. Answer is 25 watt. Now, question number 8. Question number 8 is very important. A pump is used to lift 500 kg of water from a depth of 80 meter in 10 seconds. Suppose here is a pump and it is used to lift some water from a depth of 80 meter. This depth is 80 meter. So mass of water 500 kg and the depth h is 80 meter and time is 10 seconds. In first part of this numerical we have to calculate work done by pump. This part is similar to question number 7. So, we will calculate work done by pump. As we know, the formula for work done is Fs cos theta. I have told you in this formula, this force. Actually, we have to find work done by pump. So, F is the force which pump applies for lifting the water. So, how much force pump will apply? So let the weight of water is mg, which acts vertically downward. So for lifting this water, pump has to apply force in upward direction, at least equal to mg. Pump should apply force to lift this water upward equal to weight of this water. Okay, so F is mg. The weight of water is mg, which acts vertically downward. For lifting this water, pump has to apply this force equal to this weight in upward direction. So force applied by the pump is also mg, but in upward direction. H is depth or height, and theta is angle between force applied by pump and displacement. So pump is applying force in upward direction and displacement of water is also in upward direction. So angle will be zero. Now the work done by pump is given by W is equal to mgh. This is the formula which we have used in question number 7. This was the explanation how this works. Now put the value of m, this is 500, g 10, h is 80. So it becomes 4 into 10 to the power 5 joule. Now in second part, the power at which the pump works. In second part, we have to find power at which this pump works. So power is equal to W over T. We have value of W, 4 into 10 to the power 5 upon T is 10 seconds. So it becomes 4 into 10 to the power 4 watt. This is the power at which this pump works. Now we come at part C, last part of this question, which is very important. There is some terminology in this question, in part C. Now in third part of this question, we have to find power rating. Power rating of pump if its efficiency of 40%. So power rating, we have to find power rating. It means power input. We have to find power input, and efficiency eta is 40%, which is 40 by 100, by 100 for removal percentage sign. Now the formula for efficiency is output, power output over power input. Okay, this is power output over power input. So efficiency is 40 upon 100 is equal to output power is this power at which the pump works. So output power is 4 into 10 to the power 4, and power input, so power input is equal to power input is equal to 40 into 10 to the power 4 into 100 upon 40. So it becomes power input is equal to 10 to the power 6 watt or 10 to the power 3 kilowatt. For convert this watt into kilowatt, divide this by 1000. So in this part, we have to find power rating, which is power input. So we have to find power input. This is efficiency. Efficiency of this pump is 40%. Efficiency means if 100%, let's say the efficiency is 40%. It means if 100 joule energy is supplied to this pump, then this pump convert only 40 joule energy in useful work. This is the meaning of efficiency. Efficiency means efficiency, here efficiency is 40%. It means if 100 joule of energy is supplied to this pump, then it converts only 40 joule energy into useful work. So efficiency is 40%. We will remove this percentage sign by dividing 40 by 100, and efficiency formula for efficiency is output over input. So output is 4 into 10 to the power 4, and we have to find input. So input is 1000 kilowatt. So always remember, power rating is power input. Now, question number 9. An ox can apply a maximum force of 1000 newton. We have an ox and it can apply a maximum force of 1000 newton. It is taking part in a kart race and is able to pull the kart at a constant speed of 30 meter per second. So constant speed V is equal to 30 meter per second. While making its best effort, calculate the power developed by the ox. We have to find power in this question. As I have told you, for calculate the power, we will use formula P is equal to W over T. Power is rate of doing work. So we use formula P is equal to W over T for calculating power. But here in this question, the value of force and speed are given. We don't have work in time. So how can we calculate this? So we know W is equal to Fs upon T, and S upon T, displacement over time, is speed. So F into V. So we have another formula, P is equal to F into V for power. Always remember, we have two formulas for calculating power. P is equal to W over T and P is equal to force into velocity. Now I have explained this formula. So in this question, this simple question, P is equal to F into V. F is 1000 and V is 30. So this is 30,000. And what will be the unit? Watt. Now question number 10, question number 11, and question number 12, you have to do with yourself. This is your homework. Now I will do question number 13. So question number 13 is, it takes 20 seconds for a person A of mass 50 kg to climb up stairs, while another person B of same mass does the same in 15 seconds. Compare the work done and power developed by the person A and B. So we have two persons, A and B. A takes 20 seconds for doing some work, and B takes 15 seconds. Let's say TB and say TA. Time taken by A and time taken by B. Mass of person A is 50 kilogram. Mass of A is 50. And mass of B is also 50 kilogram. Compare the, and both the person climb up stairs. So the value of height for both person is also same. Okay. Now we have to find work done. We have to find the ratio of work done. Compare the work done in first part. So work done by this man, WA is equal to MGH. So MMA G and H. Here work done by B is also we will use formula MGH. MB mass of B, G is same for both and H is same. So the ratio of work done WA over WB is equal to MAGH over MBGH. And in question it is given that mass of both person are same. So their ratio is 1 by 1. So the ratio for work done is 1 by 1 in first part. Now we have to compare the power developed by both the person. So power is in second part, power of A is equal to W upon TA and power of B is WB upon PB. So compare these PA upon PB, WA upon TA into TB upon WB. We have seen that WA over WB is equal to 1 by 1. The ratio is 1 by 1. So it will cancel and TB is 15 upon TA is 20. So the power developed by both person are in ratio 3:4. The ratio for work done by the both person is 1:1 and the ratio for power developed by the both person is 3:4. Now, question number 14. A boy of weight 40 kg of climb up 15 steps, each 15 cm high in 10 seconds. A girl of weight 20 kg of does the same in 5 seconds. So, it is this numerical is quite similar to question number 13. So, in this question, we have a boy and a girl. And the mass, the weight of boy, weight is also force. Weight of boy is 40 kgf. So, weight is also force. So FB is equal to MG and BG is equal to 40 kgf. And we have to convert it into Newton. We do all numerical in SI system or CGS system. That's why we have to convert this kgf into Newton. Kgf is non-SI unit for force. So multiply by 10. This is 400 Newton. Now, the weight of girl is Mg. G is equal to 20 kgf. 20 kgf means 200 Newton. And boy take 10 seconds while girl take 5 seconds. And number of steps is equal to 15. And height of each step is also 15 centimeter. Both boy and girl climb up a stairs and number of total step is 15 and height of each step is 15 centimeter. So total height of stairs 15 into 15 225 centimeter or 2.25 meter. Okay, this is the height. This is same for boy and same for girl. Now compare the work done. So work done by the boy is equal to MBGH. So MBG is equal to 400. We already calculated the value of MG and H is 2.25. So this is 4 into 225 and this is 900 joule. And work done by girl is equal to MGGH. And MG for girl 200, H is 2.25. This is 450 joule. In first part, we have to compare, also compare these work done. So after comparing WB and WG, 900 upon 450, 2 by 1. The ratio is 2:1. This is the ratio of work done by boy and work done by girl. Now, we have to compare also power. So, in second part, power of boy and power of girl. Power of boy is work done by boy upon time taken by boy into power of girl, time taken by girl upon work done by girl. So WB upon WG is 2 by 1 into TG, time taken by girl is 5 seconds and time taken by boy is 10 seconds. So this becomes 10 by 10, 1 by 1. So the ratio of power developed by boy and girl is 1:1, and the ratio of work done by the boy and girl is 2:1. Now, question number 15, you will do yourself. Now, last question of this exercise, question number 16. A boy takes 3 minutes to lift a 20 liter water bucket from 20 meter deep well, while his father does it in 2 minutes. Compare work, power, and how much work each does. So, for boy, a boy takes 3 minutes, t is equal to 3 minutes, convert it into second, 180 second. Lift a 20 liter water bucket, 20 liter water bucket, mass of water 20 kg. I have told you 1 liter is equivalent to, not equal, 1 liter is equivalent to 1 kilogram. So, M is 20 kilogram from a height 20 meter deep well. While his father does it in 2 minutes. For father, time taken is 2 minutes. 2 into 60, 120 seconds. So in first part, we have to compare their work. So work done by for boy, work done is given by MGH. So m is 20, g is 10, and h is also 20. This comes in joule. And for father, work done by father is also given by mgh. So same values are there, joule. So ratio for work done by boy or work done by father is equal to, we have seen the values for work done separate. This is 4000 joule. This is also 4000 joule. So the ratio will be 1:1 for work done. Now in second part, power developed by them. In second part, we have to find power developed, compare, comparison of power developed by both of them. So power for boy and power for father is equal to work done by boy upon time taken by boy into time taken by father upon work done by father. So WB over WF is 1:1, and time taken by father is 120, and time taken by boy is 180. So the ratio of power will be 2:3. Okay, so the ratio for power developed by boy and father is 2:3. Now in B part of this question, how much work each does? How much work each does? So the we have calculated the value for work for boy and for father separate. Okay, but in this solution I have taken the value of g is 10, while in question the value is given 9.8. So if you put 9.8 here and 9.8 here, then you can calculate the actual, you can calculate the value of work done by boy and work done by father separately according to the your textbook. In your textbook, in this question, the value of g is given as 9.8, not 10, but I have taken 10. So you can put here 9.8 and you can calculate the value of work done for father and for boy. So this exercise, the numericals of this chapter are completed. Your homework is from this exercise question number 10, 11, 12 and 15. You have to do it yourself. If you have any problem, you can comment, you can ask. In next video, we will discuss some theoretical, some short questions of this chapter 2A, and after that we will begin part B of this chapter. So complete your homework.